Hi there folks, in today's demonstration I'm going to show you how you can remove unwanted characters from a string in Power Automate using one action. So no apply to each, no variables, a very simple way to remove unwanted symbols or numbers from an existing string. So if that's something that interests you, please make sure you like and subscribe, and without further ado, let's jump into the demonstration. So I'm going to kick things off from a manually triggered flow, and in order to accept an input string, I'm just going to add in an input parameter here, and we can call this string. Of course, your string can come from anywhere within the flow, but this really makes the demo easy for me today. I'm going to add in an action first up that is going to enable me to store a string of symbols and characters that I want to remove from the string that I provide to this flow. So I'm going to remove all of the symbols from the top of my keyboard here. I'm going to ask it to remove all of the numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0. And I'm also going to go for vowels as well, so A, E, I, O, U. And you'll note that I'll put these in twice, both upper and lowercase, because what I'm going to show you is case sensitive. So we need to make sure we cover both upper and lower. So the aim is to remove these unwanted characters, or potentially keep these unwanted characters, depending on what your use case is. But this demonstration will show you how to both handle keeping and dropping the characters that are in this string. So next up, all I'm adding is a select. And this pretty much is the end of the demo. All you need for this process is a select. And the input to a select needs to be an array. So an array is, of course, based on those square brackets. At the moment, I have a string, which is not an array, but I can use an expression called chunk. And what chunk will do is it will take a string, or in fact, another array, and it will chunk it into smaller arrays. But because we're passing in a string here, and if I set the second property as one, it'll actually turn the string that I provide to this flow into an array of characters. And we'll have a look back at that in the history to understand that in a bit more detail. So by chunking that string into an array, what we can do now is toggle this select into text mode, and we can actually just use a condition. So again, into the expression editor, there is a condition called contains, and contains will look at both an array or a string to see if the value that you provide as the second property is contained within that string or array. So with the dynamic content, if I insert this unwanted characters compose output, and then compare it against item. Item, of course, is each of the individual characters of that string, because I've chunked that string into an array, and that's what ultimately item refers to, is each object or value within an array. So by doing so, we'll get a true or false. Is that value contained within that string? If it is, we'll get a true. If it's not, we'll get a false. And I would be at this point looking to wrap this in an if statement, but I'm going to add this expression as it is and save and test, and we can have a look at the output in order to understand why it works. So as I test the flow, it's going to ask me for an input string, and remember, it's going to remove the vowels, so the A, the O of Demo Bird, and also it's going to remove numbers, so I'll put 365, but also symbols. So I'm going to put some of these symbols in amongst this string so that we can see them being removed as I run this. I'm also going to copy the string so I can reuse it. So if I run this now, what will happen is we will get an output from the select of trues and falses, and we can now see that on screen. So where we've got no match, we have a false, as you can see here. D is not in our original string, but where the letter A, which is a vowel, exists, we have a true. And similarly for that exclamation mark, because I added all the symbols, again we have a true. The lowercase m is not a vowel or one of the symbols or a number, so we have false. And we can use this logic to our advantage to either return the letter that's in this existing array or to replace it with nothing. And so that's exactly what we're going to do now when we edit the flow. So back into this expression, I'm going to go to the start of our contains, and I'll insert an if. And so that's going to check if something is true or false. If it is true, then we're actually going to output nothing, in this case, two single quotes. If it's not true, then we are going to output the item. And so this will enable us to create an array of either the values we want to keep or empty values where we don't want to keep. And if your requirement was different, if you wanted to keep the characters within this string, then you'd simply swap this round. Rather than having your double single quotes for the true, you would have item as true and then the double single quotes for the false. So I'll go ahead and update this, and just to complete the flow, if I go and add in another action, we can return the completed expression, and we can do that using a join expression. And so all join will do is it will take an array, in this case our select, which is all of our individual characters, and we're going to join that based on nothing, which is single quotes. And if I add that, we can save and test, and we'll have an updated string. So with the flow and test, if I paste in that similar expression from before, what we're hoping for is for this to drop any of our vowels, any of those symbols, and also those numbers. So actually we should just end up with DMBRD, hopefully. So if I run that flow, and if we look at the new string, we can see we have as an output DMBRD. We've removed the vowels, we've removed the symbols, and we've removed the numbers. If we have a look at the select, we can see the input, which is our chunk of that string that I provided, and then we can see in the output where the condition is false, we are keeping that character. Where it's true, we are just simply inserting nothing. And when we do the join, we actually remove these nothings to create a string that does no longer include those unwanted characters from our compose. Now, if your requirement was slightly different, if we go back into edit, if we think about this select statement and this if expression, this if is based on a true false condition. So if something contains, it's true. If it doesn't, it's false. Now there's also other opportunities to use expressions like is int. So if a value is an integer, we could actually just keep all of the numbers. So again, if we apply the same logic with is int on item, we can check to see if there is a number. If there's a number, it's true, then we can drop it. Otherwise, we can keep it. But if we swap this logic round as well, and if I move these single quotes to the end of the expression like so, what will happen is we'll actually keep the numbers rather than dropping the numbers, because we've reversed the true false logic here with the item to keep or to drop. So without using a compose, we're able to use this isInt expression to check if the value within this item is an integer. If it is, then we're going to output that value. If it isn't, then we're going to return nothing. And so what we'll do when we test this, we should get the numbers back 365. So with the flow in test mode, if I paste in that string from before, we should hopefully get the output of the numbers 365. And if I pop open that compose string, we can see there in the outputs, I have just the integer values from that original string. If we look at the select, again, those chunked individual characters. And then if we look through the output here, we can see everywhere that there's no match, we've inserted an empty value. And where there is a match, we've kept that value by using the expression item. Now this would be particularly handy if you're receiving alphanumeric strings with numbers in them, and ultimately all you want to do is keep the number. Very quick, very efficient, and as you can see, it's simply one action. Just to remind ourselves, it's the select based on a chunk. We chunk up that string, whether that's a subject in an email address or any other string from a Microsoft form, etc., and we chunk it into one size chunks, which gives us that array. And by chunking it up, we can then use this simple if expression based on a true or false. In this case, we're looking at an integer. Previously, we were using contains. And then depending on whether or not you want to keep it or drop it, we just simply reverse these two values. If you're looking to keep it, if it's true, then you have item. If you're looking to drop it when it's true, you move the item property to the false value of our if statement. And that's all there is to it. So I hope you've enjoyed that. I'd love to hear how you might use that in your own flows. And if you've got any ideas for future videos, please make sure you leave me a message and I'll have a look and see what I can do. So thanks very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again sometime soon. Cheers.